Let's talk about the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. This team's Super Bowl chances are done as they went one and done in the playoffs, and it's one of the rare times we've seen Tom Brady go one and done in the playoffs. This team was too Tom Brady dependent, and a lot of people are putting this onus on Todd Bowles or putting this onus on Byron Leftwich. They expected too much of Tom Brady at this stage of his career. Tom Brady is still a very good quarterback in the NFL, and he still has a lot of game left. But for him to throw the ball for over 40 times a game, going up to 50 times a game, is ridiculous. They couldn't run the football, and the offensive line has been an issue for the entire season dealing with injuries. And they got Ryan Jensen back today, but it didn't matter as much. He dealt with injuries, and he was super rusty. The thing is with the Dallas Cowboys and how they routed this team, they got outcoached. Mike McCarthy outcoached Todd Bowles, and Todd Bowles did not have this team prepared and ready. Underneath Bruce Arians, they did not suffer ugly losses like this at all. Bruce Arians had the offense more suited up, and things was ready, and things were clicking. Todd Bowles is a good defensive coordinator, not a good head coach, not a guy that can focus on both units at the same time. And we saw him get exposed this season. They went 8-9 this year, and that defense that is supposed to be so far amazing underneath Todd Bowles got routed today against the Dallas Cowboys. Against the Dallas Cowboys team that were struggling the last couple games. Give Dak Prescott credit, but this defense for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers was horrible, and this offensive line was horrible as well. So you can only expect so much out of Tom Brady, and when he has a lack of a run game, it doesn't help as well. The thing is with Byron Leftwich, I do think that he will leave this organization. I think that he could be a good offensive coordinator somewhere else. Far as being on this team and coaching Tom Brady, it's just not going to work. Both of these coordinators got exposed by Bruce Arians. To see how this offense has declined in 1 year since Bruce Arians has left has been something that I thought I would never see. Tom Brady is still a good quarterback. Mike Evans is still a good wide receiver with Chris Godwin. But it was a lot of miscommunications, and the offense was not suited up and buttoned up like how it was underneath Bruce Arians. And it was just a complete Byron Leftwich system. We have seen the valueness to having a guy like Bruce Arians on your roster and letting him be the head coach of your team. Unfortunately, he had to retire due to health concerns. And you insert Todd Bowles in there, the defense was not the same. And I get it. Shaquille Barrett's been injured, been dealing with a torn Achilles. He missed a lot of games this year. But even when they still had Shaquille Barrett, the defense still was not holding up their part to end. Remember what the Kansas City Chiefs did to this team earlier in the season. Remember what the San Francisco 49ers did earlier in the season. I said for weeks now and for months now that Todd Bowles was not a good coach, not a good head coach of this team. Defensive coordinator? Yes. Head coach? No. It comes down to the conservatives on fourth down to punt the football when it's fourth and short and you have one of the best quarterbacks ever play football. They have no run game to depend on. The schemes do not work with this team, and the offensive line is a major issue, but Byron Leftwich always wants to run the ball up the middle. No toss plays, no sweep plays, no end arounds. And we saw a lot of that years prior with Bruce Arians. And it just seems like they just went plain vanilla offensively, and they went plain vanilla defensively as well. Todd Bowles was not sending the same blitzes that he was, and they were in a close game in the last game of the season with the Carolina Panthers. And they won that game because of the hurt secondary of the Carolina Panthers. When Tom Brady went no huddle, when they went tempo and Tom Brady was making the audible adjustments, they scored more. When it wasn't that, it wasn't the same. They have two coordinators on this team posing to be top end head coaches, and it just doesn't work. I think Byron Leftwich, when he goes to a different team, he may be a better offensive coordinator, but for this team, it's just not going to work, and the plain Jane system doesn't work as well. They resulted back to what they were earlier this season, to Tom Brady dependent, and they can't run the football with Leonard Fournette or Rashad White. I feel like Leonard Fournette will not be on this roster next year, and they need to bolster up this offensive line. Far as Todd Bowles, you can keep him as a head coach. I wouldn't. I think he deserves to be gone. The management, the clock management, and the team management as a whole is not it. He will be an excellent defensive coordinator in the NFL. That is his role. We need to stop trying to talk guys into being head coaches when they're just good at being a certain coordinating position. Just because he's a good defensive coordinator does not mean he'll be a good head coach. Ask the New York Jets about it. They'll tell you. Todd Bowles has a loaded roster, even with the injuries, and Tom Brady, Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, and he still wasn't able to do anything with it. And this defense still has players like Devin White, Vita Vea, Antoine Winfield Jr., and they still weren't able to get any stops this year. This was Tom Brady's first loss against the Dallas Cowboys, so it'll be very interesting to see what Tom Brady does moving forward. If they keep Tom Brady, good. If they don't, they're in for a massive rebuild because they have to go out there and get a quarterback that will suit this team. You still have to fix the offensive line, and you still have to fix the defensive woes as well, and you're going to be looking to get a brand new head coach. But let me know in the comment section below, how do you feel about Todd Bowles? Should he be back next year? His team went 8-9. They could have went 9-8 if they would have played their starters for the majority of the game against the Atlanta Falcons, but they had a lot of embarrassing losses this year. They could only beat up on teams that were subpar 500 or below 500. They couldn't beat teams above 500 or the top tier teams in the NFL. And the roster says that they can. The coaching doesn't say so as well. So let me know in the comment section. Say bring back Byron Leftwich and Todd Bowles for one more year, or should they get rid of both of these guys, and who should they bring in? And give me a name besides Sean Payton, because a lot of people want Sean Payton to come back, but I want to see a name besides him. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. If you like the video, hit the like button. Most importantly, want each and every last one, guys, stay safe, stay positive. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Peace.